The invisible force is back in Bird Box Barcelona, moving the unseen threat that drives people to witness their biggest fears from the USA to Spain. The focus of this expansion, that takes place at the same time as the first film, is Sebastian, a traumatized father who must travel across the city with a group of survivors he meets in the hope of finding sanctuary. With action and scares as tense as this, we'll forgive you for needing a little recap on what happens. So close those curtains, ignore those ethereal voices, and settle in for Bird Box Barcelona Explained. Oh, and do be warned, there are spoilers incoming. Bird Box Barcelona immediately wrong-foots viewers with an early twist. Sebastian is a seer. We discover in an explosive opening, Sebastian has visions of his dead daughter, Anna, who is tricking him into forcing groups of other human survivors to witness the mind-scrambling threat. In a bus crash, Sebastian takes out an entire group of survivors, and this thrilling scene took 2 weeks' worth of preparations to get right, which included help from engineers and physicists to figure out how to get the height of the ramp and speed of the bus right to pull the stunt off safely. Anna promises him that if he delivers enough people to the unseen force, he'll be reunited with her and his wife Laura. Sebastian's quest from the visions of his dead daughter leads him to a group of survivors who are just trying to scrape their way through the now ravaged city. These include Claire, a British doctor who was on a book tour when she got trapped in Barcelona, as well as a German child, Sofia, who has lost her mom. When meeting them, Sebastian doesn't waver in his plans, going so far as to engineer a situation where the group head out of their shelter and towards Montjuïc Castle so they can split up on the streets of Barcelona and at the mercy of the unseen force. However, a conversation with another survivor, Octavio, as well as his relationship with Claire and Sofia, leads Sebastian to question whether what he's been experiencing is divine intervention or demonic.
Or fears, or grief, or pain.
We'll explore that more later. But why do the survivors decide to leave their safe house and travel to Montjuïc Castle? Well, it's meant to be impenetrable, only accessible via a skyline tramway and a safe haven for the lucky few who haven't had a face-to-face meeting with the invisible force hunting them. Secondly, Sofia reveals to the group that her mother was planning to take her there, giving them a reason to see if they can reunite the young child with her mom. While the group is initially split on whether they should leave their underground compound, with Roberto being the main dissenter, the group decides that due to their lack of supplies and the potential of reuniting Sofia with her mom, they will brave the perils of trekking across a now desolate Barcelona. Great news for Sebastian, bad news for the rest of the group, especially poor old Rafa. Sebastian is already starting to have doubts due to his burgeoning friendship with Claire and Sofia. He's able to talk to both of them in their native languages, as Claire is English and Sofia is German, which helps build a bond between the trio. Plus, Sofia is a similar age to Sebastian's own daughter, Anna, which seems to trigger a more compassionate response in him. Then, there's Octavio's theory that the invisible things that are terrorizing humanity are creatures he refers to as quantum beings.
Are some kind of quantum beings?
His explanation is that the creatures are constantly changing until they encounter a human, when they will begin to prey on a person's fears or desires to get them to do their bidding. This, along with his new friendships with Claire and Sofia, caused those doubts to intensify even more. Sebastian tricks Octavio into seeing a creature and witnesses him stab himself to death. Instead of seeing his soul ascend though, he just sees a pool of blood bubbling, causing the deceptive Sebastian to worry that he might not be doing the right thing after all. On their way to Montjuïc Castle, Sebastian and the remaining survivors are chased down by a group of seers led by Father Esteban. While Roberto and his wife Isabel are caught by the gang, the other three, Claire, Sofia, and Sebastian, are able to escape indoors. When they get here, Claire and Sofia discover Sebastian is a seer himself and try to outrun him. However, he chases them down and goes to remove Sofia's blindfold. It's at this moment we see a flashback that reveals what happened to Sebastian and his daughter. They're surviving in their apartment when Father Esteban and his gang find them, drag them out of their home, and onto a roof to reveal the creatures to them. Esteban forces Anna to open her eyes, and when she does, she runs off the roof they're on.
Ven a ver, papá.
Sebastian, consumed with rage, goes to fight the priest, but sees the invisible force himself, which reveals a vision of his daughter to him, promising that they can be together again if he delivers enough souls. This tragic moment is what has been fueling Sebastian's misguided journey. In the present day, Sebastian loses his faith in the creature's visions and decides to save Claire and Sofia instead, keeping Sofia's blindfold on and helping Claire up.
Claire,
Sebastian, Claire, and Sofia try to escape the group of seers in a car that gets them to the Skyline tram that'll get them to Montjuïc Castle. Once they make it, they block the entrance with their car and set it on fire, creating a temporary barrier of flames. Sebastian tells Claire and Sofia he'll buy them time to escape and stands ready to confront the seers, with Father Esteban trying to convince him to let them through said fire. Sebastian doesn't relent, and Esteban walks over the burning car and through the fire. Sebastian stabs him with an iron rod to stop him from getting to Sofia and Claire, ultimately sacrificing himself to save the others. Claire and Sofia get to the top of the tram line, only to see that none of the cable cars are working. Claire realizes they need to signal their presence to the castle and rings a giant bell that gets the castle's attention, but also the attention of the creatures. Despite the best efforts of the invisible force to convince Claire and Sofia to take their blindfolds off, they successfully ignore its devious callings and manage to leap onto a cable car to safety. Once safely across, we discover that Montjuïc Castle is indeed a safe haven, with a community that includes Sofia's mother. The castle has workers growing food, children safely playing, and an army patrolling the grounds. All's well that ends well, right? Nope. There's still one final twist to keep them up at night. After Sofia is reunited with her mother, Claire is taken to a room where she's told that she'll need to give some blood for tests. This is to see if she has a genetic marker that could be the key to creating a vaccine against the invisible threat. When asking the doctor taking her blood about how they would test it, we get a glimpse of these disturbing experiments in action. It turns out that the army has managed to capture one of these invisible creatures and store it in an iron cage. They're using animals, like mice, to test their vaccine, with blood being taken from a chained-up seer. The last shot is of another failed experiment, as mice are put into the cage with the creature and their hearts stop, all while the seer screams that he wants to see the creature. Can the army find a solution to this problem? Or are they dicing with death by running these dangerous tests? And that's the thrillingly eerie Bird Box Barcelona Explained. Let us know your theories in the comments below, and remember to subscribe to Still Watching Netflix for all the latest news and deep dives into your favorite Netflix shows and films.